G'day, Westy here. Thanks for tuning in. Got a bit of a disclaimer. I am not a financial advisor, so please don't take anything I say as a financial advice at all. I'm purely here for you to educate and teach you, and obviously learn as much as I can to do that, either from you guys or from reading and watching and learning. So enjoy, and let's get on with the show. So now what we're going to do, we're going to install a program called Balloner Etcher onto our machine, and what that's going to do is going to give us the ability to clone the Hive OS from the USB stick that you've pulled out of your rig onto an SSD drive. It also allows you to do a fresh install of Hive OS, which I'm going to go into in another video. So basically what you want to do is go to Google or your search engine and type in Balloner Etcher, and that brings you to this website. Now this website is the main download for Balloner Etcher. Go to Windows, or if you have Mac OS or Linux, go to the appropriate image and then download the software. I'll actually do this again. Put it in a location that could be a good working file for your crypto stuff. Hive OS, that's it. And I'll just save it to here. And when it's downloaded, it shouldn't take that long. It's not that big a file. Click and open show in folder, and this is the file here, and then just double click it, and it actually opens a program straight out. It doesn't install it, it doesn't go through the whole process to install it. It just wants to work on it. So I'll just close this down for now, and we'll open it up in the next part of this video.
On the show.
So what we're about to do, we're going to basically, this is a Hive OS loaded onto this USB stick. And I've got an SSD drive. This is a 120 gig one. And you're going to need a USB to SATA drive converter. So this takes quite a while. So you just connect it in like so, and then connect the USB into your computer, and then your USB, so your SSD drive into your computer, and your USB drive also into your computer. And then plug your SSD drive also on your computer. And then what we're going to do, we're going to open a program called Balloner Etcher. B-A-L-E-N-A, Etcher. This is a portable one. Double click on that. And this will open the software that we need to convert or image a clone of the USB drive. So we want to go clone drive. We're going to select my USB traveler, which is the small USB device, which already has I've already put Hive OS. I've just pulled this out of my rig, and the main reason I'm doing it is, one, because it's got intermittent crashing problems, which I believe might be writing errors on the drive. I can't tell because it's not logging anything, because it just crashes, so that could be it. And the other thing, it takes ages to load drivers and change drivers and all that sort of stuff. So so this is your source drive, which is, you're going from the USB, select target, click on that, and then go on mine's the physical 120 gig Kingston drive. So just be careful and make sure that you are using the right one. There's no warranty on doing this, so don't tell me that I told you to do it. So you've got to know what drive you're using there, and go select. So that's your source and your target, and then just flash. And this takes a little while to do. Yeah, it does actually take a while. So I'll be back in a minute. So now that the drive has been flashed and validated, you can now remove your SSD drives. You might notice it might come up on the screen in a little rectangle box. Windows asking you to format the drive. Don't do that, just cancel it. It might do it twice because I think it creates three little drives. So just cancel that, don't format it, otherwise you'll be starting again. So just remove your drive. And then you'll find, I've found that there's a massive difference between the boot time of a USB setup, Hive OS or any drive, to running an SSD. It's a way, way, way faster. You've got no bottlenecks. It's very, very quick. And you should see your system come back online in less than, I'd say, 45 seconds from when you, I can go out to my workshop, plug in this new drive, and by the time I get back, it's actually seeing it on the network, and then it takes about another minute, and it starts mining, so it's fantastic. So yeah, I'm pretty pleased with figuring that out. So yeah, these aren't what they're cracked up to be, the old USB drives. SSD is the way to go, it's real quick. Even better, you can go to an M2 if you're running a motherboard that's got an M2. But yeah, they're way faster. All right, so that's pretty much it for this video. And tune into my other ones. Hope you enjoyed it. Cheers.